It's like I know I'm supposed to go do class over time. But it's too late. I'm already done. I got a midterm? One number below that can say whenever X is wrong. Wait. What? Which of the four is the way to warm up eggs? What will not make Pokemon easier to catch? What will make it easier to catch a Pokemon with higher levels? How do you like the Pokedex? They won't let me take it again. First of all, they cheated me on the question. They definitely cheated me out of that question that they didn't ask. Thank you. move that my primate has to learn to turn into an annihilate? If you use two Pokemon that are from different languages to breed, they become shiny faster? Catching them yourself or training with other trainers. You can get a new Pokemon only by catching and training with other trainers. Fox. If a Pokemon is holding an Everstar when using an item that induces evolution, such as a Firestarmer, Ain't that the lady that was just rap battling? I get critical hits a lot more often than 4%. Still there, shadow clone, about 12% chance. Can I say use movie called Focus Energy during more of the direction? Both raise the critical ratio by 2 stages. That's a 50% chance to land the critical. Holy crap! That swing the luck in your favor may open the door for more strategic choices for your life. I got this. I can do this. This is easy. She teach by day, rap battle by night. Okay. How much damage does water gonna do if it's a fire type? Double. How much damage does razor leaf do when it hits a fire type? Spend 2,000 on 200 Pokeballs. How many do you get? What is the percent chance of landing a critical? How much damage does a move deal when it lands a critical? I better get 100 on this. Spore Dance, on the other hand, boosts attack by 2 stages at once, allowing the Pokemon to deal double damage just after a single use. Using Spore Dance twice would boost the Pokemon attached by 4 stages. makes sense. Four dance plus four dance is four stages. That's quadruple. Pays off. Going to class. Look at this. So if you use tackle 100 times, you'll land 100 tackles. The move hypnosis just puts opponent to sleep and has an accuracy of 60, which means you can expect it to hit 60 times out of 100 uses. And then a truly powerful move often tends to have more accuracy, and that's all of them. And when deciding whether to go slow and steady, with moves that are sure to hit, are hard and fast, with stronger and less accurate moves, for staying probability. Perhaps surf and hydro pump. Yeah, yes, you will hit many surfs over hydro pumps. Surf has a power of 90 and accuracy of 100. Hydro pump accuracy is 80, but it has a power of 110. Trading accuracy for power, or vice versa, is purely a matter of preference. Surf versus hydro pump debate has been ongoing for quite some time. Personally, I'm more invested in debating rock type moves like rock slide and soul dash. Is this? Where is the lady with the Gengar? Oh, she wants to talk about stab. Stone Edge, the move's base power of 100 is multiplied by 1.5 to become 150. Ground or rock may seem similar to move, but if ground type Pokemon with the 100 power. If Pokemon shares the same type of move, the user who uses it hits an opponent that is weak to that type plus the move's power. Or if a Pokemon Terracelizes and the Terra type matches one of its original types, then the bonus it gets for using the move of the same type increases from 1.5 to 2. I knew that the Terra was making it stronger, but I didn't know it was going to 1.5 to 2. I just knew it was better. How many balls could you get if you purchase 3,000? Each one costs 600. What if a water type moves with a power of 100 lands a critical hit? A grass type Pokemon overload power. What is the chance Storm Edge will land a critical? If a Pokemon uses Sword Dance twice, it boosts its attack by 4 stages. How much damage do its physical moves do? If a Rock type Pokemon who uses Terra type Rock, still got the same reward though, so I guess it doesn't matter how well I do. I just have to pass. I don't know, 1,000? Bam, 2,000. I don't know. certainly have undergone repairs. It's just as it was built so long ago. I would certainly prefer it to not have the Pokeball portion though, a relatively new addition. Approximately how many years ago? 805 years ago, to be precise. In other words, your academy was here 805 years ago. Oh, my bad, bro. I was just saying what you said. How you gonna get mad at me for saying what you said? At the time, it offered the state of art facility that such people as the same. Those seeking knowledge may look no further than the images of Palpatine. That's right. Referring to the Narahan Academy. This ends today's lesson. Our next class will be on our midterm exam. I better pass this midterm. I'm not even good at history, but I better pass this midterm. Summon your historical knowledge from the dark recesses of your mind. What is the name of the geological formation? The Great Crater. What was long believed to rest in the depths of Area Zero? Treasure. How many years ago did the Pallian Empire? 2000. How many years ago was the Academy built? 805. Those seeking blank need to look no further. Knowledge? I know I passed. See, hey, look at I'm fucking good, man. A vessel, a sword, a set of tables.
a set of beads. Solar table vessel beads. Okay. Shower the merchant with gold coins and claim all four treasures for himself. But she didn't even tell me what this was. I don't like her. I don't like this class. Does anybody enjoy her class? I don't like this class. I almost said handheld devices, I'm not gonna lie. Terrible disaster rained down upon his castle, reducing it to rubble by dawn. Oh my gosh. Where did she get the Articuno necklace? Can I get that in the stores? I want an Articuno necklace.
Your task concerning the great crater area zero. This mysterious crater captured the imaginations of many. 200 years ago, completely explorers claimed to have finally reached its depths. The name of that team that achieved this feat was Aerial. That's a weak name. Area Zero Expedition. The team is said to have been made up of Palaeta's best invites. Skilled battlers, brilliant researchers, and talented individuals of all kinds. Among the list of team members was the name of a man who was an author of brilliant natural history, Pete. After returning from the expedition to Area Zero, he used his literary talent to record the events of the expedition and publish them. The name of the team who made it Area Zero Expedition. To pick up on. The record of that activities written by Heath can be found in bookstores even today. This is known as the Scarlet Book.
Huh! Look at that! They tied it in! They did it! They did it. They used the title. There it is.
Scarlet Book was so popular they practically had everyone had a copy. However, the book itself was full of fantastical descriptions and illustrations that could never be thought of as real. The masses began to call Heath a liar. Even the truth of the expedition making it to the bottom of the crater was called into question. Scarlet Book was condemned to the shelves of used bookstores as just another book of wild paranormal stories. There is a copy of one of the bookshelves on the ground floor of the entrance hall. Feel free to read it if you're interested.
to start from present and study history in reverse. As of course, I have no choice but to let the flow of time carry us forward towards the future. In the last class of ours, I should fill your minds with the history of terrestrial phenomena. The technology behind Terra Orbs has origins in Area Zero. Wait, so if he went to Area Zero and he brought back Terra Orbs, why did people not believe the story in the Scarlet Book? That doesn't even make sense. He brought back something to prove that he was right. More than 40 years ago, Pokemon Cloak and Mysterious Light were discovered there. As you may have guessed, these were terrestrialized Pokemon. However, when those who discovered these Pokemon brought them out of Area Zero, the light faded, and the terrestrial Pokemon remained a mystery for quite some time. However, 10 years ago, that might as well be present day, a certain someone you have definitely heard of unraveled this mystery. What was the name of the famous professor that unraveled? Clayton? Professor Sada unraveled the mystery of the terrestrial phenomena. She discovered that the shining crystals down in Area Zero, or rather the energy emit, is what causes Pokemon to terrestrialize. This led the professor to invent the Terra Orb technology for practical use. This technology was then shared with both Pokemon League and our academy. Rumor has it Director Clavel was the one of the researchers on the professor's team. Alas, the story is less exciting now that we all know peers in it. Modern history truly dull, isn't it? Let's go. Summon your historical knowledge from the dark recesses of your mind and answer the questions. What is the area called? Area Zero. He did not have a folder. Where is your expert member? Keith? How many years ago did Professor Sada get Terra Orbs? Did she say 15? It was either 10 or 15. Dang it, it was 10. So, Haru or Happy? For this chance to re-experience my younger days with you all. Do you know what Salvatore means? It means savior. save you from spooky new languages. My class will teach you about the various languages from different regions. You must say good morning or hello as a greeting. But people from other places may say bonjour or salut. I've heard there's even a popular streamer out there who smashes several languages together and says hello, hello, hola, ciao, and bonjour. There are so many regions out there in our world. Gracias, merci, chichi, arigato, donkey. These all have the same meaning. Can you guess what it is? Thank you. Speaking up is important in language too. Gracias, merci, chichi. These words all mean thank you. Despite meaning the same thing, but it will sound the same. And now, for purpose of nothing, let me give you all of my wise words of advice. When you travel abroad, you should speak the local language best you can, even if you can't speak it very well. I'm sure your willingness to try it will make you people of you, Atreus Herlin, make very happy. Honestly, from my experience, just being able to say hello, delicious, and thank you in a local language will get you pretty far. For everything else, just pretend you're Mr. Mom and gesture away. Oh, that pesky bell, because it's all the time we have. Adios, matane, et la prochaine. See you later, everyone. I thought he was going to teach me something about, like, the unknowns or something. Or, like, the meaning of Pokemon games or something. It is Bruce Fritz. Are you ready, everyone? You can answer with yes or we. Class, I believe you taught thank you. And of course, there are certain in today's class we will, and by certain words, make people happy when you travel abroad. But where you ask, well, I'll let you'll have to guess. It's delicious. Oshi. Wonderful. First step in smooth communication is to compliment the person you're talking to. It's not very likely that a compliment will put someone in a bad mood. This doesn't apply to people in the other regions either. Same goes for all of you, but this to use with your classmates. Pokemon's blueprints. Are you ready? Yeah. Maybe. My lessons are not a one-way street. No, no. I am Trace Treestead. When it comes to no one's beast up. Very sad. In our last class, I believe I taught you all how to say delicious in other languages. And today's class, Curse de Hot Heat, we will learn about very special phrases you can use to put the time just right. I should do gentlemen, te amo, each leap each. It's so very important to express your feelings about things to each other, especially true for positive emotions. If you get married someday and argue with your spouse over something silly, all you have to do is apologize and say I love you. And fuck, and I'll be, and all will be well. I should know that just last week I had a big argument with my fine, my dear wife, that is. But I was quick to say I'm sorry, and all is well. Now, I propose on nothing. Let me give you a few words of advice. It's best to be quick to apologize when you have an argument. That goes for your family's friends and your crushes. I know you can do that. Our crocheting course, our next class, will be the midterm exam. Adios. That was kind of a lot. Prince, are you ready? Gracias means thank you, which word means delicious, eat. Which of these phrases don't belong? Time to eat. When speaking with a person, what's the first step to smooth compliment? What is your beloved teacher's name? Is it Salvatore or Salvador? I think it's Salvatore. Yes! Oh gosh, I knew it. I was like, I think it's Salvatore. Midterm complete. Leading up to the midterm, we're all social risks and agree. So today we'll be throwing a curveball. We'll begin listening comprehension. From Pikachu. As you just heard, Pokemon also use words to communicate. not always easy for us to understand them, but their words have meanings just as ours do. Pokemon can use languages to share all kinds of information, like the location of food or whether there may be predators nearby. The same Pokemon cries may sound different depending on what they were used to say. I'm sure you're all curious, so our pure key today, that is, let's learn some Pokemon language. He's angry. And they clap for my boy. Pokemon too many times while watching them during picnics, they'll get mad at you, just like Pikachu's demonstrator. This man brought out Pikachu again.
I don't even know anymore.
That's sad. Did he just faint? Almost through languages. Oh, this man brought Pikachu back again? Alright, at least we consistent. We consisted on learning Pikachu languages. language is final. Let's go. Are we doing old stuff too? Giga, that man's mad. Giga, Cha is happy. Last time we learned about terror raids. Terror Pokemon are super strong and more difficult ones will use tougher tactics that you'll need to deal with. The Terror Shield. It takes way less damage than one. It has a big effect on my round too. When trainers see that shield go up, they feel doomed, like there's no way to win the battle. So here's a question for you. If a Pokemon you're battling puts up a Terror Shield, what do? Terrestrialize and attack. We go all in, baby. We go all in. Doing enough damage to a Pokemon with a Terror Shield can destroy the Terror Shield and break that Pokemon's stance. This means it's important to properly time your Terrestrializing and Terror Raid battles. In conclusion, as they say, fight fire with fire and Terra Pokemon with Terra Pokemon. Be sure to work together with your teammates and smash through your opponent's Terror Shield. She wanted us to do some hands-on practice. Next class is midterm. Bet money. The higher a Pokemon's special defense, the less damage it takes from special attacks. Which of the following has no effect on a move's damage? The move's name. How many trainers are in a Terra Raid team? 4. What is an effective method for breaking your opponent's Terra Shield? Terrestrializing an attack. What is Ms. Dendra's favorite type of Pokemon? Fighting? I think it was fighting. I'm not sure, but I would think it was. battle studies. I actually like this subject. Languages was hard. I had to speak Pikachu. Also, if a Pokemon loses an auto battle, it'll come back with just a small amount of HP left. Make sure you heal it up right away. Does anyone have any questions? Can I catch wild Pokemon in auto battles? If you let your Pokemon battle on its own, it's going until its opponent is defeated. If you want to catch a wild Pokemon, you'll need to battle Ishrin Queen. Auto battles as much, so don't work them too hard. In conclusion, auto battles only work if a trainer and their Pokemon have a relationship of mutual trust. Be smart about how you use auto battles so you don't lose the trust of your Pokemon. I actually like the battle studies gun. I've been using them a little bit. Cause it's pop quiz time. Oh no! To create TMs, you'll need Pokemon materials and LP. Exchange Pokemon materials at the TM machine to get LP. People have been getting LP illegally with a technique called hacking. I don't want any of you getting involved in bad stuff like that. Anyway, you can also add TMs that you want to make to your watch list. This will let you keep an eye on materials you need to gather. Make TMs, you need Pokemon materials. If you want to get holds of lots of materials, you'll have to battle all kinds of Pokemon. singles and link battles. Singles or doubles? Some of these rules are just no restriction rule set. Let's use all Pokemon and stay at their current level. Let strangers use multiple Pokemon of the same species and multiple types of the same held item. And if you choose normal rules, all Pokemon will be set to level 50. Normal rules let you use multiple of the same Pokemon species. The great part, as everyone said, is that it lets you have any of your Pokemon participate. All they have to do is learn some good moves. Lastly, we will set called flat rules, mostly over 50. Such Pokemon will be set to level 50. Flat rule set is the one often used for official tournaments. This rule set does not allow trainers to use multiple Pokemon of same species or same held item. Ritual set, should you pick if you want to use a lower level Pokemon and keep its level? Flat. You got some clever strategy that you need to use at a level 5 Pokemon for, your best bet is to choose flat rule set. Of course, you can choose no restriction if you want to battle with any Pokemon you want at any level with any held item. That's confusing. Normal rules adjust all Pokemon to level 50. Flat rules let you use lower level Pokemon at their actual levels. That made that so much simpler. Why didn't she just say that? She really did make that, like, kind of confusing. Battle final! Which tier boosts attack and special attack? Oh, wow. What do we call battles that Pokemon sent out auto battles? How should you obtain LP? Exchange materials. High level Pokemon are adjusted to what level when using flat rules and link battles? Level 50. Using normal rules and link battles, you can use multiple Pokemon of the same species. False. Four out of five. What did I miss? I mean, I passed it, but what did I miss? Two more classes. Pushing through. I'm out here getting all edumacated. I imagine many of you will forget all that you learned in this class once you graduate. After all, you don't even need a basic understanding. I don't mean to suggest there's a correct answer. The important thing is that you all take the time to think about it. Think about whether you might find beauty in a flower on one side of the road. The question is simple, a different shade of blue. Contemplate clinging to the bite of the waters of the Cascara. I'm sure you will find every little detail of your lives will seem more vivid and more impactful if you just take a moment to stop and think. And I'm certain that if you stop and truly appreciate the little beauty of the world, it will help pull you through the days where your studies have exhausted and dampened your spirit. Poverty for the physical is like a life. To put it simply, it's true that one doesn't need art to survive, but it makes it certainly enjoyable. Next time we'll try a little more hands-on approach to it. Oh, it's a Gibbet. A Gibble. Come here, little Gibble. Wait, if you would be so kind as to test your lines. He just terrorized the lines in the middle of class? Ooh. Yeah, that was pretty cool. But by terrorist arrest, it succeeded in changing it. So what type do these lovely cracks? Oh, his classes are fast. He has some fast classes. Is he gonna terrorize me? Now he's ice? This time we have a different shape. Type moves will not be very effective against them. Keep that in mind. Usually they would deal quadruple damage to Gibble. Now here's some trivia about snowflakes. While snowflakes come in many shapes and sizes, you not feel the great mystery of nature, the beautiful enigma we live in? Dust glasses are awesome. I almost forgot to mention that you can change Pokemon's Tera-type at the Treasure Eerie. Though I must say, the cook there is a little prickly. You'll need to get on the good side if you want to help. Midterm, here we go. What's the name of the gemstone? Terra Jewel? I think he said it's a Terra Jewel. Well, the answer to question one is the shape of flowers. What does it represent? Grass. Snowflakes are classified as hexagons. The eatery in Medali? There is no correct answer. I think I got that Oh, it's that gym leader I beat. Rendering Sunflora. Can anyone tell what mood was I when I crafted its detached expression? I had resolved to give up my life as an artist if that piece did not receive proper recognition. What's the name Surrendering Sunflower? I started out as an artist, experienced any hardship, became deathly ill, and fell into a slump that drove me to desperation. I began worrying only about what would sell. I was concerned only with fame and fortune. But all of my pieces during this time had no depth. They were all shallow trash. It was then that I met Haas, and he helped me realize how petty I was being. I'll spare you the details, but in the end, I was able to leave all that behind and That is also when I crafted the Sun Core. Remarkable. Even I did not know the full story until now. This kind of thing is hard to tell someone, especially when they are close to you. Now I doubt that you adolescents will often find your heads crowded with worries. My advice to you is simple. Be honest with yourself and do whatever your heart desires. So long as you do not cause trouble, that is. That is all from me. I must admit, I am beginning to feel a bit embarrassed. I bid you farewell, boss. And farewell to your pupils as well. Is this man crying? Have any of you heard of the 10 sites of Apollo? The 10 sites in Apollo is considered to be particularly beautiful. Among them, I would say the Grand Olive Orchard is likely the most accessible. You can see field after field of olive trees from the hill on the way to Cortondo. Two waterfalls are counted among these 10 sites, Fury Falls and Casaroya Falls. Then there's the peak of Glacido Mountain, known as Paldia's highest peak. There's another cliff on Glacido Mountain that's named after its rather unique shape. So let me ask you, what is the name of the three-pronged cliff on Glacido Mountain? I did not know that, but I just kind of figured. Exactly. It looks like taking hold of something. Looks like a Pokemon's hand grabbing something. There's also mountains in Area 3 of the East Province where you can get a good look at La Vincia. It's particularly gorgeous at night. In fact, it's so brilliant, it's known as the Million Volt Skyline. Like the hot spot for dates and a romantic view. And a selfie spot. Of course, you may feel not all 10 sites live up to their grandeur's names. How often do we visit tourist spots only to be disappointed? Not that you shouldn't visit them, only that you should keep your hopes in check. The important thing is to go yourself and see them with your own two eyes. Take a chance. Last class. Both ribbons and marks are special honors that capture a Pokemon's qualities. There will be time when your Pokemon gives maximum effort and has noteworthy experience. In in recognition of its feats and accomplishments, it can be given a ribbon. To give an example, if you manage to become incredibly close to a Pokemon, it may be granted the Best Friends ribbon. Incidentally, there is a person in Karskarfa who can give you your Pokemon a Best Friends ribbon. Marks, on the other hand, are found on wild Pokemon when you meet them for the first time. They symbolize the character of Pokemon. It's a riding mark, a bigger mark. It's completely up to luck whether you run into a Pokemon with this mark. So if you're able to catch a Pokemon with a mark, rejoice at your outstanding fortune. Does anyone know what special things you can do with Pokemon that have ribbons or marks? Titles. What's more, they can be sent into battle displaying a title of their choosing. Go Gible the Great Friend. Oh, I didn't know that. And while I know I just said that marks are generally found already on Pokemon when you get them for the first time, Pokemon can be awarded certain marks based on their efforts, such as the Gorman mark, the Item Fighter mark, the Partner mark, and so on. Or perhaps it's fun to try out how to get each mark using its name as a clue. Kill this final. We're gonna knock it out. The treasure. What is Brass's the surrendering sunflower? How many waterfalls are there? Where can you find Million Volt Skyline? Was it Kamapoko? The marks a Pokemon has are present when you first meet them, and none can be added later. False. Alright, only one more class left. Oh my gosh, who is this? Ooh, Mr. Sagura. Sagura. This man look like he eat lumberjacks. When you eat sandwiches on your picnics, the HP of your party Pokemon will be restored. You'll also gain something called meal powers, can provide them all manners of benefits. Easier to catch, EXP points. You'll also find that the breadth of these effects can be expanded by crafting sandwiches of superb flavor. Ooh, I can craft superb flavor sandwiches. Okay, okay. What must you keep in mind to receive even more helpful meal powers? Put my heart into it. The choice of ingredients and fillings. He could have let me have it. He could have let me have that one. Using sweet ingredients in your sandwiches may help you gain egg power, including Nubra's bitter ingredients. On the other hand, will give you item drop power. Learning to aim for specific effects when crafting sandwiches will most certainly make your culinary endeavors more enjoyable. Please be aware, however, that you can also receive meal powers by eating at restaurants. Our time together has come to an end for today. I must bid you all farewell. You can receive meal powers and even restore HP of your party Pokemon. Unfortunately, as I'm sure you're aware, it's not suited for use in battles. In times of those, you should use potions. Healing items are immediately effective and you can be used anytime you open your bag. The pricier the item, the more HP you'll restore. However, unforeseen happenings are inextricable part of traveling from place to place. Imagine the following scenario. You find yourself with an injured Pokemon, but you have no potions, you're out of sandwich ingredients, and there's no Pokemon centers nearby. Tell me, what would you search for? Berries? See something drowning, shiny on the ground? Pick it up. Pretty sure I'm good on Pokemon eating. We'll see though. He might come up with something like super awesome that I would not think of myself. So power points. The Pokemon is out of HP. What about it uses struggle? Each move has its own store of PP, so you can mitigate PP loss during a variety of other moves. Just using one repeatedly. If a Pokemon is all PP in this move, you'll be able to use Struggle. Yes. It can restore that Pokemon centers along with HP. Items such as Ethers, Max Ethers can also restore. Be careful not to confuse potions with Ethers in the heat of battle. Do not waste these moves unless you wish to run out of PP quickly. Man, it looks like a villain. Straight villain mode. Villain turned home ec teacher. increasing speed. Which of the following affects the kind of meal power received of fillings and condiments? Which of these berries can restore HP? I think it's Aurin. Leandro wanted his Pokemon to decide on his own when to use the item in battle, so he gave it an Aurin that he spoke to work. Yeah, this is true. If a move runs out of PP, it can no longer be used. If a Pokemon runs out of PP for all its moves, it can only sit there and for frustration falls. Little half stroke. Despite this, he is baffled at his inability to increase the effectiveness of his meal powers. Since you did quite well in the midterm, what should this young man do to increase the effectiveness of his meal powers? Make food with other people. Increase effectiveness of meal power, sandwiches must be filled with many different ingredients for a single person. This may prove difficult, but if you pair sandwiches with others, you'll be able to handle a larger serving of bread. With a larger base to start with, it becomes quite simple to add more ingredients to your sandwich, which in turn makes it possible to receive meal powers for increased effectiveness. This applies more broadly as well when dealing with a difficult issue. Working with others to solve maybe the best course of action. Sure, our room will likely realize that in the future. This man said, whoops!
Don't run up on him after we get done with this lecture.
Yeah.
Appreciate y'all.
Now, I don't mean that it becomes suddenly a shiny Pokemon. I'm speaking of it becoming filthy. Pokemon battle. They get hurt by moves used against them. They get battered by wind and rain. They get covered in sand and mud. They get filthy. I've seen a trainer walking about with their adorable Pokemon without addressing the issue. It's deplorable. Let me ask this question to someone who I'm sure will not tolerate such conduct. What should you do if you're clean? I knew I could count on you to provide me such an answer. I didn't even know that the picnics you could clean your Pokemon. Putting them through a Pokemon wash. This will get your Pokemon clean and shining bright as a Terra Jewel. Currently is quite a bit of work, but this will also restore HP and cure condition statuses.
forever. Some Pokemon may have parts of their bodies they don't want to scrub, or that they would rather not get wet. Be sure to keep this in mind. Now, the most important point I must mention is that some Pokemon like to be dirty. Though I contradict myself by saying this, please do remember that cleaning your Pokemon is not always the kind thing to do. Our time together has always come to an end for today. I bid you all farewell. Wait, your phones, it's time to be in our last class together. Closing. Our academy has an air of freedom about it. Our seasonal uniforms, the diverse climate of it. However, students are free to wear whichever style they please. As you receive 4 sets of items. If by chance you were not aware of this, you may wish to pursue a wardrobe. As long as you wear a school uniform, the rest of your ensemble need not be school issued. This includes your bag or your hat if you choose to wear one. Drum song phones. There's a shop called Deli Burp Presents where you can purchase cases for your Rotom phone. I shall go myself tomorrow to get a Robo case of my own liking.
Egg final! Let's do it!
After this, I'm probably gonna take a small little intermission break. Sparkling power? Which of the following is not the effect of egg power? What is a simple yet important tactic for increasing the effectiveness of meals? Make meals with others. Question about academy rules, should you change your uniform top and bottoms to properly match each season?